This video explains you how to assign variables to the PLC memory addresses and to physical IOs of a PLC. When your PLC needs to communicate with external devices like an HMI panel or a sensor or an actor, it is necessary to use global variables that are assigned to fixed PLC memory addresses or respectively IO addresses. So how do we address hardware IOs of the PLC? Let's make an example. We assume that we have connected a digital sensor on one of the 16 inputs of our FP0H PLC. According to the manual of the FP0H PLC, it states that the hardware inputs are addressed by the letter X using hexadecimal addresses. Generally, you can directly use these hardware addresses in your program, but we strongly recommend to use variable names and to assign them to the according hardware address. This simplifies later the reading of the PLC code for the programmer. So, therefore, we define a global variable now, which we name G_B_sensor. When we connect it, for example, a sensor physically to the input X0, we need to enter in FPWIN Pro 7 the address X0 to assign this hardware address to the variable name. Accordingly, when having connected a physical relay on the output Y0 of the PLC, we would need to enter the address Y0 and assign it to a variable name. How do we address the PLC memory then? Here I defined already some global variables and assigned the most common data types. To assign a Boolean data type with an internal PLC memory address, the letter R must be used, followed by a free address number of the internal memory. To assign an integer, word, or string data type, the letter DT is used, followed by a free address number. To assign a double integer, double word, or real data type, the letter DDT is used, followed by a free address number. Let's also clarify it by a practical example. Let's assume you want to communicate with an HMI panel and you want to share following values. A live bit that tells the operator that communication between PLC and HMI is established. The error codes of the PLC must be displayed on the HMI panel. We define therefore a global variable of data type bool called G_B_livebit and assign this variable to a free PLC memory address using the automatic assign functionality. Here the memory address number 2 is still free and therefore chosen. The error codes of the PLC would be natural numbers, so we need to define a global variable of data type integer called iErrorCode and assign this variable to a free PLC memory address also using the automatic assign functionality. If you need more detailed information on how to address the PLC memory, you will find it in the FPWIN Pro online help. You may wonder why there are shown two different addresses for each variable. The only difference is that the FP addresses are the Panasonic notation, which is the notation that is most commonly used. However, if a programmer is used to the international IEC notation, he could also use this notation. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching and feel free to check out the other videos on our website. Panasonic.